Okay, now, can this guy not come after me? It's a test. He's rocking an old caddy. And me, I'm just trying to look for a job. Bookmark. I want one of these. Which stunt race do I know? Duel. That one is, that one runs with the muscle cars, because I have promised you guys something. And I want to fulfill that promise. First of all, this is kind of dependent on whoever is hosting this allowing custom cars. Ah, looks like I'm the man here. Let's just get rid of this. Let's see, custom vehicles on, muscles. Hey, two laps, time of day, blah, blah, blah. Looks like it's good. Confirm the settings and auto invite. Because what we're going to do here is we're going to race the Independence Day Special. That is the goal. We're going to put that big old American hunk of iron on the track and see how it does, how it fares. If nobody signs up for this, I'm running it alone. I'll be sad, but I'll be running it alone. I think this would be the first time ever that I didn't get like a really kind of semi-full track with one of these things. Oh, come now. Every time I've hopped in one of those pink circles, there has been a slew of people, literally a slew, that are trying to get in on the race. And here we are gathering additional players. This does not bode well. Illuminatolini. All right, we got one guy. Triple C Crazy HD, or Crazy High Def. Crazy. It's a mano a mano, and he's the Joker. Okay, that's a lot of effort. I think we should give him an A for effort on that. I think that's good enough reason to race him in the Independence Day Special, which should almost guarantee him a win. This won't be the last time you see the Independence Day Special, I guarantee you. Because I want to do this for the full race at some point, but I want to get at least one race on the track just to see how it'll perform, if it can even do the loop-de-loops, because it's so long. .137 lost 128. Boy, I don't know. That's not exactly the WL ratio you'd hope for. Here we go. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. Boom. Okay, I've got the Independence Day Special. I got my top hat on. Right. And we'll take this to the right. Maybe he'll take left. How does it handle? Actually, surprisingly well here. It feels very stable. It's a little wide. This is almost too easy to drive. Okay, there it drifted a little bit, but I mean, don't get me wrong, I am not flat out through some of these turns. I was flat out through one or two of them. Just made the jump. I am, it's okay. Now I'm we're right at the same point where we're neck and neck, either on different tracks. And this is just fast enough to make the jumps, just. Somehow, the fact that it's a more stable driving platform is making up for the fact that it has a lower top speed. This is the trick. Look at that! The Independence Day Special has promise here! That is probably the fastest I've come through that turn. Again, barely enough to make the jump. And he's in a Dominator! Now great, this is an extremely tough track to get around in a Dominator. Because it will fly off the edges. You know. That's my personal best time on this track. Here, I thought this was going to be a joke. And it might be. Maybe it'll be a joke when we have a whole bunch of, you know, really experienced people who are experienced with the Dominator. Know exactly what you're doing with it, you know. Not that I'm one of those people. You've seen my races. You know how often I DNF. But wow, you can really take these turns quick. Waiting relative to what the car can do. It can't go as quick as the Dominator. So it's keeping it in the states. It's making it easier to drive. Ladies and gentlemen, if you struggle with driving muscle cars, and you want to do these races, I would highly recommend trying this, because... Alright, it's just barely fast enough to make the jumps. That scares me a little bit every time. And this loop is definitely dicey, there's no question about it. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, finally made a mistake. Came out of there a little bit too aimed too far to the side. Make it, make it, make it! Oh, not fast enough. Alright, this could cost us first. So you have to not hit the wall there. I still haven't perfected the exact way. You have to line the loop up perfectly. I'll say, figure we're looking at a 2 minute 10 here, 2 minute 15 for the couple of wrecks. Look, that's how, this is unbelievable. I am not believing it. It's easy to drive. This car is just easy to drive. Boom. I thought, well, here we go. Now we get to watch the Dominator. How's this guy doing? He's just overdriving it. That's easy to do. That happens all the time with the Dominator. The Dominator is probably the fastest of the muscle cars, but it is touchy as heck. If you're good with it, you'll blow everybody's doors off, and I'm not necessarily good with it yet. I gotta tell you right now. But if you told me I could have taken this Big Chino and done anything really cool with it, actually won a race, I would have said you're crazy. This close to 115. I mean, I realize it's a custom car, but that's not a winning custom car. Let's click like. Let's give the guy a good game. Let's see. What one do we want to take now? Let's see. Give him. Team.
time your headshot.
Confirm the settings. Oh yeah, we don't want to. Well, maybe. Everybody else is gonna be doing this. Trophy drug. Oh, I forgot to change my outfit. Okay, there's all kinds of different possibilities for destruction here. We boost up. Oop. Ah! Okay, I'm cutting him some slack there, to be perfectly honest. If you have told me I could have actually beat somebody in the Chino. Well, it just is really stable. For that track, I might want to try, I'm going to try that again the next time it comes up. I'm taking the Chino out there. I'm taking the Independence Day Special for a romp. First time on this track. This takes a little bit of control. Whoa! Hey! Now, there's something to be said there for that. Let's call this a forgiving vehicle. Whoa, are we getting chopped out here? Oh, you gotta be getting through! Yeah, we made it! Boom. Well, so far I'm liking the trophy truck, I gotta tell you. Now, a motorcycle will win in one of these races. You know, 99 times out of 100, unless they get run over. And I'm cool with that. I think the trophy truck would have a chance. You know, real, real straight up, because especially if we can make these non-contact, Rockstar. We have a non-contact stunt race. I know I should toggle the stunt cam every once in a while, just for looks. On this particular set, of course, I imagine the motorcycle would have a huge advantage. But on the flip side, if anything goes wrong, it's one of those blades. Not gonna be, you can get killed, probably. Not that that matters in this world. Everyone dies 10 times a day. I do plan on saving up and buying one of these trucks here. This for the Badger. Maybe both. I do like them both. I'm curious as to which one is going to be my go-to off-road racer. Or will I just keep running Sanchez? I don't know. Should I get myself a custom Sanchez? Okay, we're a little bit off. Ooh. Yeah, we're significantly behind here. He's definitely outpacing me, and that bike will probably run a lot faster. It's just that simple. boost notwithstanding. I wonder if this, which is quicker, one of these or what the heck are you called? That kind of sci-fi looking dealio. Brawler, a pit bull, I forget. Yeah, there we go. Let's roll. I somehow got points for that. Oh no, stop it. No radio. We don't want any kind of complaints from the Germans. New complaints from the Germans. Who like to ban my videos in Germany? Boom, baby. No stunt cam on that one. 50 RP though. Adolescence? What the heck? That we changed the radio and did the stunt cam there. All in one shot. That's its own kind of epic, really. I'll have to bookmark this one so we can try out. This would be a good test track to go solo on. Just do time trials and see what's faster. We'd love to try this with the 6x6. All right, then we actually got to the waypoint there. And there's more. I wonder if there's a way I could just, is there a radio, a quick radio turnoff kind of thing? Gotta be pretty close to finishing this thing off. I wonder if I'll DNF this one. I'll be honest, I expected this truck to have a little more speed. Not that I even really looked all that closely at the stats. Or even at all. Oh, here we go. 22 seconds. Can we? Now, instead of just bopping around here in this quiet little race. I'll be honest, I wonder why it's so quiet tonight, because, you know, there's... It's just a Monday night. 3, 2, 1, no. Boom. Dinif. Is everybody watching the Republican National Convention? You can have that on the background. Hey! 115! There you go. Rank it up. Hi. Why so serious? Click like. We'll bookmark the job. So at least I can try that to do a little... That'll be its own video. Alright, we have to show this guy the downtown loop. We have to. Because that's one of those things where it's anybody's game. You know what I'll even do? I'll turn custom... Well, we'll leave it on, but I won't run a custom vehicle this time. I'll pick one of the defaults. What? I'll kind of pick one of the new ones. No, we won't do that. No. Ooh, the FMJ. And the FMJ in the only way you've ever seen a real one, in blue. And you're like, a light blue? Blue? Let's go with that. It's FMJ time. Ready to play. I'm still in my standard outfit as opposed to my all-American, because I keep forgetting to change that up here. That is a weird thing, that where it changes your outfit. But still, this is my standard outfit for the most part. I can rolled up jacket thing. Alright, DFMJ, of course, this is the their version of the new Ford GT. This is just should have some pretty awesome stats to it. I probably, just to be fair, I shouldn't have done the whole turbo jump thing there, the whole turbo start. Oh, well, he's catching me. And let's see, will he bump me in mid-turn? Uh-oh, I swerved to avoid him. If you land it, then they give you bonus points. Here's another request. Rockstar, could you give us a channel of music that will not get us banned in Germany or anywhere else? A channel of royalty-free music. Yes, that's what I'm looking for. Can we hit this? Whoa! Now, having fallen off, that gives me a couple opportunities here. Number one, lets me kind of really try to focus on going all out and see if I can catch him. And it gives me a chance to really feel the FMD. This does have a nice feel to it. Of the new non-stunt cars, this is the one I kind of been leaning towards eventually getting. The X80, I think, might actually be a little bit faster because it's a little bit lighter. Wow, that just looks so cool. This feels a little more stable. As I say that, I loop it right out of the sky. This is a particularly strange part of the track, I gotta say. Wall ride it as far as you can. Whoa, we're just flying here. Fun map, yeah. True that, I'm trying to catch up though. Let's see, can I in the middle of the air find the N key? This is true. I don't think that was the N key. I think I hit the B key. This is true. N's a little bit of a reach from that hand. Come on, along. Oh, okay. Hold on. The default is the N key. N for Norman, I guess. Ah.
Can you hear me?
Loud and clear. I tend to accidentally hit the B key myself. It's true. That's just, yeah. Let's see. Right now the goal is, because he's apparently got this down, he's not having difficulties flying off the track. Whoa, there he went. I am closing on him a little bit. At least I was able to see him. Through the fireworks. Turbo. Okay, we're off a little bit. This is bad. Just a little... little bit off on that.
Same here. I can't see where I'm going.
Well, the mouse looks. The mouse look works, but I mean, you know, it's I find it's better to let the car just kind of readjust itself. If you just hold forward, eventually the camera will adjust itself back so you can see what's going on.
If I hold forward?
Yeah, just hit the gas. It'll eventually autocorrect. It would, you know, I don't know. Are you using a controller or are you using a keyboard and mouse? I'm a keyboard and mouse guy, so that's the only thing I know. Canyon Crossing is another good one. Would preferred plummet. I'm surprised that these aren't filling up faster, because usually the last two times I've done this, this was almost a full race. This time we'll use the just to show it off. I had to recover after I wrecked the darn thing. I have to say, of these new tracks, I haven't found one where I've said, this is terrible. They're all pretty cool.
Yeah, I like these.
Probably going to be my last race for tonight. I'm going to have to hit the hay pretty soon. Tapped the e-brake there a little bit and lost it. Thought I'd do a really fancy-dancy slide through the turn. Didn't quite work out as I'd hoped. On the flip side, I am in my entity, which should have more top speed than any of the stock cars. And a little bit more brakes. Let's see, now we've set ourselves a challenge here. The fact that I've raced this course a few times. I don't know if he has. We are moving here. And a grooving. That should have been some bonus points there, a little RP. Thank you. turbo, turbo. We are in fact closing.
This is a pretty cool map.
It is indeed what we would call funky.
Funky.
Am I dating myself there with funky? I don't know. It's. You might have went to go touch to respond to that. This is for you. Don't expect the underground section. You really don't. Considering the mistakes I've made on that, that's we have to work on a new personal best here. They just hang there for so long. Ooh, yeah, he had an accident. Okay.
Well then.
And the but you didn't go for those turbos next to the landing, did you?
No, I was trying to do a backflip and I tried it again.
Okay, well that's a worthy thing to try.
It's hard, man. It's really hard.
A lot can go wrong there, no question about it. But if you pull it off, you do get some points. It does look cool. One thing about these tracks is there's a good many ways that things can go horribly wrong. Things are going well, you're feeling proud of yourself, someone bumps you just a little bit where there's no guardrail, and phew! Tried to slide it through. Half the time I'm coming off these jumps, I'm thinking it's gonna blow up when I land. It's gotta blow up. They're just too high. Sometimes that happens. It does actually. You land it not quite right. You were on your way there. You almost had the backflip going. Well, good racing, my friend. I'd like to hang out with you and keep going, but I gotta take off. Have a good one now. I gotta go.
You too.
Very fun racing with you, my friend. on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Black Knight. Have a great night. Much like the Independence Day special was before it was the Independence Day special, I had it black and gold, much like this car. I'm very fond of the paint job on this. I really am. You know, check this thing out here. I mean, it's just, you know, it just it can hop good. You know, we got the whole that going for us and all that. But I think, again, very much like the Independence Day special, I think this car has a higher calling. And there she is. The all-new St. Patty's Day special. Yeah, I could have gone green on green with a little bright green where the gold is. But I thought the gold accents the green so much better this way, don't you think? I mean, it just has... It's a little shift from the black on gold. It still has the same kind of feel. Gave it the lime green neon kit. That should be really cool at night. But at least now we have the St. Patty's Day special. We'll be all set for March. Added, of course, to my holiday cars collection. There you got it. You got the whole moonbeam. Checking it out as I kick back here. Where else would you want to spend St. Patty's Day? Seriously. Cruising St. Patrick's Day with all your friends. This would be a perfect thing for the Scranton St. Patrick's Day parade. Cruising this thing. Maybe with the hood down, but I mean, still, doors wide open, rolling through. Okay, here's a personal challenge. Can we get this to its parking zone with everything still on it? Whee! Up! Oh, it's starting to close up. It's going uphill. Everything shut up except the hood here. Oh, there goes the hood. Couldn't hang on. Well, you gotta give the mechanic something to work on, right? Maybe that could be a look for this thing, you know, just take the hood off altogether. Fixed already. Alrighty then, at least we got that going for us.